What is ricin and how difficult is it to make it?
Well, ricin is a byproduct of the castor bean, which is a naturally found plant. It's in nature. And we derive castor oil from the castor bean. And in the course of processing to get castor oil, one of the unused byproducts is ricin. Now, when ricin is purified, and you have to have some laboratory knowledge to do this, purified and produced in a light powder form that can float and be inhaled, it can be highly dangerous, lethal. 1 or 2 grains of salt would be the equivalent size of the amount of ricin that could be lethal to a human being if a person ingests or inhales it.
That's incredible, and there's no antidote, right? So how common are ricin attacks in the U.S.?
The actual attacks, very, very rare. There have been instances when some white supremacist groups had either had plans to or actually did produce some ricin, and they've been stopped. It has not been a generally used bioagent. You know, first of all, it is a biological agent insofar as the castor bean is a plant. It's a biological material. We generally think of bioattacks as coming from bacteria or fungi like anthrax or a virus like smallpox. But ricin is easily available in terms of the potential for making it into a dangerous material and weapon, but it has not been used extensively by any means.